Hello everybody and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. I have quite the treat for you today. We're going to take a look at our new Rockwood GeoPro 12RK. There is a lot packed into such a tiny package. You guys are going to fall in love. Now the Rockwood GeoPros, they're a brand new line from Forest River. There's only about five models of them, and they are all designed to be lightweight, easily towed by, well, you could almost tow this with your bicycle. You can't really, but it's close. So these units are fiberglass exterior, they're vacuum bonded. This unit here, this is for the person who wants to be an RVer, but they don't want to be your typical RVer for a couple of reasons. It has that unique teardrop, kind of old school feel, but as you can see, it's updated. Let's call it like the IKEA teardrop, right? That's what it kind of reminds me of. So it's designed just for one person, maybe two people, because it has a small kitchen, you have a bed. It does have a lot of appliances you're gonna need, so let's start going through this. I wanna unpack all the features for you because there's a lot to show on this tiny trailer. All right, so now on the front of the GeoPro, you have your wraparound fiberglass cap. You have your diamond plate to guard against rock strikes. This is typically where you're gonna have those occur. You have a little docking light you can flip on and off to help you either hook up or disconnect during the evening. You have a spare tire right down here, obviously, for if you have a issue with a tire. Battery compartment is right here. There's also a battery disconnect on this, so you can kill all power to the coach and save your battery life if you're gonna be storing it for a little while. You just disconnect this red switch right here, and that'll take care of that. You have a 20-pound propane tank, and that's nice because if you run out of propane on this, which it's gonna take a long, long time to run out of propane on something this size, you can just go swap that out. And of course you have your tongue jack right here. And this thing has a very, very light tongue weight on it. You can almost pick it up, I cannot, but somebody stronger than me probably could. It's, again, you can put this on just about anything and tow it. Your total dry weight on the coach, actually let's just talk about GVWR, so your gross vehicle weight on this coach is 1,922 pounds. That's under 2,000 pounds with a full load of cargo. So you can haul this again with just about anything. The dry weight on it is 1,254. So you have almost 700 pounds of cargo capacity in this thing. And I gotta tell you, you're not gonna be able to fit 700 pounds of cargo in this. But in case you wanna try, up on top, you're gonna notice right here and here, they give you some, a rack for cargo. Now you can actually purchase from Rockwood whatever you need to go in between those two bars there, and you can haul kayaks or bikes with that if you want to. Now coming down from the roof, you have your axle, you have your tire here and a wheel and axle. So these are torsion axles. They are independent, they have independent suspension from one another, which is a really nice feature on the coach. You also happen to have your water fill right here for your water tank. You have a quick connect here for a solar panel. So if you want to set up a portable solar panel, you can do that and just connect it there and you're charging your battery. This is for your city water connection. This is for your 30 amp connection if you have shore power, and then your cable and satellite inlet. Now let's talk about the inside here real quick, okay? Here, come on in here with me. So this obviously is your main, your only room in the 12RK, but there's a lot in here. So obviously you got your queen bed. Now, if it gets cold in here, one thing this does not have is a furnace, but that's all right. You're also talking about a very confined space. It's not gonna cool down really quick. And if you happen to be plugged in or you have a generator running, this mattress here is heated. So this little controller, this plugs into your mattress, and this end plugs into the GFI outlet, which is conveniently located right down there for you. And then there's six different settings on this. So you can turn it up. all the way up to 6, and it'll practically cook you out of this. I mean, I'm sure you guys can be inventive and think of other ways to stay warm in this thing, especially if there's two of you. Let's not go into that. So up here, there's storage. You can put whatever you want up here, clothes, dry food. Now you also have an air conditioner, which is really nice. So this unit here, if it's plugged in, you can cool down this, and this AC will make this into an ice box for you if you want to. There's also, you have a little fire extinguisher here. There are always fire extinguishers in coaches. There's a speaker here, and you have your audio system right there. So this will play, you know, radio, it'll do CDs for you. You can even plug in an HDMI source if you want to. You can charge off of a USB port as well. And then there's a TV too that you can mount right here, and it plugs in. There's an HDMI outlet. You have your coax, you have your sound cables right there. So you can set up the TV in here, watch it if it's raining outside, listen to music, read a book, do whatever you want to do. Also, just wanted to note this too. So you have these windows on each side, each of the doors. So with that, you can actually get some cross breeze. So if it's has if there's a little bit of breeze at night, you may not even need to run this. You can just literally flip open the windows and have that. All right, and let's go take a look at the back of the coach. Now, remember, I was telling you, there's a lot packed into this coach. Come around the back and take a look at this. All right, so here you have your full kitchen. So you have microwave, you have LED lighting up here, here. You even have a speaker for your radio. So if you want to listen to music out here, you have that right there. There's a sink as well. And here you can control the water pump. So you can, if you're hooked up to city water, you flip off the pump. If you want to run off of your water tank, flip that on and it pumps away. You can also check the levels of your battery from here as well. You got prep space, and then right here, there's also a GFI outlet. So if you want to bring, you know, some kind of appliances, I don't know, you want to bring your smoothie, your blender, whatever, you can hook that up here. Now, when you're traveling, there's also a little cooktop area that stores conveniently right here and latches in with this, and we'll show you that in just a minute. Now, this is one of the coolest things on the coach. Okay, a little fridge, right? Not that exciting, right? But you know, standard fridge. Normally, you wouldn't be able to run this fridge while you're camping, especially if you're not plugged into power, because this runs on 110 only. It does not run off of propane like a lot of RV fridges do. But if you look right down here, you see that yellow box in the corner there? Now that's an inverter. That inverter is designed to take your battery power and convert it into electricity to keep this fridge cold. Now I'd recommend probably cooling this thing down, especially if it's like 90 degrees out. You might want to plug it in, cool it down, and then turn on your inverter. That way you don't drain your battery just getting it cold to begin with. But that right there, that little inverter will keep something like this nice and cold for a good long time. It also happens to have a couple of extra plugs. So if you want to run something else off your battery, you can plug into that and use the inverter to power a 110 system off of 12 volts. Now again, you have storage down here. There's also storage above as well. And then this is your converter box. This is also where you keep your fuses, keep your breakers. And then you have another GFI outlet right here. And of course, you know, I do want to also mention, obviously you have this large door that covers you up if it was happened to be, you know, raining outside. So now around the side here, we talked about the cooktop area. So here you got a two burner stove, and it folds up nice and neat, just like that. And then you literally just take it off of the wall, put it in the back there, and lock up that rear door to store this. There's a quick connect. So it comes with a little hose right here for propane. Now there's a quick connect hose that attaches to this and then plugs into the port down here. And that allows you to use your bottle of propane to power this. And then you got a little prep space here as well, you know, for hot dogs or whatever you happen to be cooking at the moment. And then down here, your other axle again, torsion axle. It is nitrogen filled. I forgot to mention that earlier. So that helps reduce the wear and tear on your tires also. Thank you guys for watching our video on the Rockwood GeoPro 12RK. I hope you find it as exciting as I do. I think these things are amazing little units, a lot of value packed into a small package. And if you would like to learn more about these products, come to our website and take a look. We have videos on the other GeoPros, we have pictures, and we have specs. And you can also give us, you can go to our contact page and contact us directly to ask more questions about it. And if you want to talk to us in person, we're pretty nice for the most part. You can always give us a call. Our number here is 970-313-4337. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider punching that subscribe button and the little bell beside it. You'll get notifications. We do post very regularly on our channel with all the new inventory that we get. And if you would like, if you have a question that you want to answer on YouTube, leave a comment. We'd be happy to answer that. Thank you for watching, and we'll talk to you next time.